It is not possible to show entire demonstration at your home. Due to that, I am going to do the live demo, which with this you can understand what all the different parameters we can do the testing. Okay, first I will show you the TDS test. That is a with the TDS meter, you will be able to understand what is the TDS level in the water. What is TDS? TDS is a total dissolved solvents in the water. It might be good solvents, it might be bad solvents. It covers everything. So if TDS is less, that doesn't mean that your water is good. If TDS is very high, that doesn't mean it is not good. Okay, there are different parameters you need to check while doing the water testing. The TDS meter is just simple measurement to understand total dissolved solvents in the water. It is not the final test. Okay, this is also not important. As per WHO standard, you need to drink a water which is up to 500 TDS. Okay, but when you say I am getting 500 TDS, whether your water is free from chemicals like lead and arsenic, and there are many fluoride contents, and there are many iron. See, many things are not required for your body. That is also comes in water. So how you will remove that? There is no alternative method apart from RO technology. For that you need to use an RO technology. When you use an RO, automatically RO removes the minerals from the water. So what you need to do for that? That I will come to explain in the next test. Of the water testing is pH test. pH means potential of hydrogen in the water. If potential of hydrogen is good in the water, then it is drinkable. Normally, what is the pH value of different water parameters? That will be tested by this meter. And there is also one more chemical method. I will also explain about that. This might not give an accurate result, but the chemical test will give the accurate result. Why you need to do the pH testing? So less than 7 pH value is called as an acidic water. Anything you drink above 7 is called alkaline water. So can I drink a 10 pH value? Is it good for my body? Yes, that is also good, provided if doctor advise you to drink a 10 pH value, because there are many cancer patients and there are many gastric problem patients are there. They need 10 pH value to help their body. Okay. Normally, initially, if you drink any alkaline water, it will not be adjustable to your body. For that, it will take 1 month time. So later on, your body will be adjusted to alkaline water. Then your health will improve. Okay. So this pH test, what is the right pH value for human body? 7.35 up to 8.5. If you drink, there is no problem. You can drink that water as long as you want. Even small kids also can drink. There is no problem. Okay. So this is about the pH meter. This test also I am going to show you. After pH test, I am going to show you ORP test. ORP means oxidation reduction potential in the water. How much oxidation is reduced in the water? That is tested by this meter. This meter normally costs 4 to 5,000 rupees. You no need to buy this, or you no need to ask us to do this test regularly. It is not required. When you use an alkaline water purifier, if it is a right alkaline filter, definitely you are going to get a negative ORP. Negative ORP is very good for human body. Reason is, our entire body, including intestine, stomach, heart, everything is in plus ORP. Everything is having more than 100 ORP. If you drink anything less than 100 ORP, it is good for a human body. It is easily dissolvable in our body cells. Due to that, you always looks young, and your skins will be more active, and your blood's circulation will be better, and blood will become easily dissolvable in our body. Due to that, our most of the diseases will go down, and our resistance power will improve, and you will go regularly, means maximum times urine, so that it will remove your toxins from the body. Okay, so this is about ORP meter. Okay, so this I am going to do show you this test. Along with this, I am also going to show you a chemical test. But the thing is that this ORP meter sometimes will not give the accurate result. Please note that. Last test what I am going to do is the hydrogen test. So please note one more point. This meter we have imported from some other country. This you cannot buy, because the meter cost only 48,000 rupees. Import cost, everything, it comes to 48,000. It is not possible for us also to come to your home and show the entire demo. So that is the reason I am going to show you this demo using all the things here. So what is the hydrogen level in the water? What hydrogen level you will get in tap water? What hydrogen level you will get in RO water? What hydrogen level you will get in alkaline water? And also what hydrogen level you will get in ionized water? So all tests I am going to show you today. After that you will understand the importance of hydrogen. If you still have any doubt why I should drink rich hydrogen water, please go to my blogs and read all the blogs, and you will get a clear picture. And if you have any doubt, you can mail me. I will send you most of my articles. My email ID is enq@panimart.com. Thank you. final test what I am going to show you is a chemical test. Chemical test to understand the pH value, also to understand the ORP value. Okay, if the all these water you can see there is no, you cannot see any difference between all the waters. All you will feel all good water only. Okay, when I put a ORP solution, the color of this water will change to pink. If negative ORP is there, then only color will change to pink. Otherwise, there is no negative ORP in the water. So that might be good, but that is not healthy water. Okay, if the water is turning to pink color, you can drink that water as long as you want. Okay. So the third test, last test what I am going to show you about the pH test with using chemicals. Normally along with your product, I am going to give this small kit. If you want higher solution, you can buy all these chemicals from our website panimart.com. It will cost you around about 960 rupees something. With that you can do more than 100 tests. With this you can do around 10 tests. In this kit, it is clearly mentioned the different colors and pH level. Whatever the color getting turned, that is the pH value of that water. Okay. So also I am going to show you using this chart as well as this chart what is the pH value of the water. Now I am going to collect the water from the tap and RO water and ionized water. I am going to show the difference between RO water, tap water and ionized water. First I will collect the tap water. Okay, so tap water written very clearly. So I will keep, this is RO water. So now you see it is alkaline water purifier, but I am going to collect water from this machine only. I have switched off the alkaline filtration. I have switched on only RO filtration. Hence, the water what you are going to get from here is only RO water. There is no alkaline water in this. The LUFP 16 stage water purifier, 14 stage, 12 stage, you can use RO UV, RO UV alkaline, anything you can use. This water I am collecting only RO so that you can understand the quality of the water. See, this is a RO water. Now I am going to collect alkaline water which is from ionizer. So now this is a Leopair water ionizer. We have imported this product from Korea, the company called Wiz. We are the authorized marketing company for ionized water purifier. This cost starts from 65,000 rupees. The advantage of this product is when you use an alkaline water, you are also going to get acidic water from here. This from here you can collect acidic water, from here you will get a ionized water, alkaline water. So there are different levels here. You can see here alkaline 1, alkaline 2, alkaline 3, alkaline 4. And also if you want purified water, you can click on purified water, you will get only purified water. If you click on acidic, there is acidic 1 and acidic 2. Two levels of water you will get. If you want only acidic, you can collect from here also. At that time the alkaline water will go from that side. Now first I will start with alkaline water. I will collect level 4 alkaline. I need only this much for water testing, so I will switch off. Now I have collected all different types of water. One is tap water, one is RO water, another is ionized water. So first what I am going to do, the basic test that normally everybody does in the market. That is the TDS test. Okay, now let us see what is the TDS level of the water. You can see the TDS level. It comes to 398. This is the tap water, which is not good for drinking. Above 300, you cannot directly drink. Now I am going to show the same water is purified using this machine. Then what is the output of the RO water? If there is the input quality of water is 398, and what is the output quality of the water when you use an RO process? It will come to 12. You see, 398 reduced to 12 when you use an RO technology. Then same water when we processed through water ionizer, what is the TDS level? It is coming to 80. Ionized water will give 80 TDS. So you understood the difference, I think. Now it is 398, 10 and 80. The TDS increased because of the ionization and minerals addition. This is called an alkaline water. Whether it is alkaline water or not, how we will check now? What I am going to do, I am going to use the pH testing kit. This is the pH testing kit. I will show you the pH value of the tap water, it will take some time. Okay, before that, what I will keep this ORP meter into alkaline water so that it will not immediately give the result. It takes some time, so hence I am keeping ORP meter. Now you see the pH value of the tap water. It is 8. Again, it's good for drinking as per the pH standard, but the water might be containing lot of harmful chemicals, metals as well as virus bacteria. That is not free from this water. Okay, now I will put the same pH meter into RO water. You can see the pH value now. Again, it will not give the immediate result. Sometime it will take because it slowly goes down. It will go less than 7. RO water will go less than 7. Because ORP meter will not give immediately result. So, hence I am keeping ORP meter inside the ionized water. So, it comes to 7.6. Slowly it will reduce. You see the pH value of the RO water, it is coming 6.2. Sometimes actually it is a 5.5. In this pH meter, it will not give the accurate result as I already told you. And also you can see the ORP meter, which is giving minus 31. Okay, it will take lot of time. It will go to minus 150, minus 200 also. Whichever is the minus ORP is good for health. If I keep the same meter from this ionizer to tap water, you see what happens. It is going to plus now. See, it is 3, 4, 5, 6, it will go to 100 plus. From minus, it is going to plus now. Automatically increases. The positive ORP, now whatever the water you are drinking at home is a positive ORP. When you drink a ionized water, though you are going to get a negative ORP. Negative ORP, see, automatically getting reduced. It goes to minus 110, 120, 200 level. But it takes lot of time, hence I am not continuing with this complete demo. But it is, you can easily understand, you can give this water to any lab. But when you collect the water for ORP calculation, you need to do testing immediately. It will not be there after 1 hour. Okay. So, this is about the water ionizer. So, I am ending this demo on water ionizer. Now, I am going to continue the demo with our LeoPure alkaline water purifier, which is a 16-stage purifier. Just 10 minutes back, I have taken water from RO. Okay, so only when it was switched off, it was switched on. Now it is off, now it is on. Now, whatever the water you are getting here, it is alkaline water. So, now what I will do, I will collect the alkaline water from this. I will show you the pH, TDS, all the parameters using this water. This is a 100% alkaline water. We are not adjusting any pH value for making you to understand better. Okay. Now, you have seen the TDS level of the tap water, and also you have seen the TDS level of the RO water. Again, I will show you the same RO water TDS. It comes to 1230. You see, it's visible. Okay. Now, I have collected the same water from the same product using alkaline method. Now, you see the TDS level. It is 26. 27. From 13, the TDS has been increased to 29. It's almost double. So it doesn't mean that this if you drink 27 TDS, it is good or bad. It is not like that. Okay, so we'll check the pH value of the same water with the pH meter. The pH value is 9.2. 9.3, 9.4, 9.5, it goes up to 10. The pH value of the LeoPure 16 stage alkaline water purifier. It goes up to 10. Okay. So same, I am going to do the ORP test. Here it is, minus 29 in ionized water. Now same meter I will keep here. You see, early when I put the same meter in tap water, it was going plus. You see, it is not going plus now. It is minus 29, minus 24, minus 23, minus 22,
it is in minus level only. If I keep the same meter in RO water or tap water, immediately it will come to plus level.
This ORP test will take some time, so I will keep the ORP meter in Leopure alkaline water purifier glass. Before that, I am also going to show you the hydrogen test. This is a hydrogen meter, as I explained to you. This will test the hydrogen level in the water, whether it is plus or zero. So if it is zero, means you are drinking a dead water. So without hydrogen, water means it is not good for health. Now I will check the hydrogen level in the tap water. You see the hydrogen level, it is zero. Tap water is not having hydrogen level, rich hydrogen level is not there. Now I will do the same test in RO water. RO means it is RO EVA, RO EVA of anything can be possible. Not necessary that RO EVA, if you drink, the hydrogen level will increase. Or if you adjust the pH also, TDS also, it will not increase. The hydrogen level in RO EV or RO EVA of water purifier will be zero. Now I will do same test in ionized water. Now you see hydrogen level is increasing. I have done test for tap, I have done test for RO. Now I am doing the same test for ionized water, which I have taken from Leopure water ionizer. Okay, you can see the hydrogen level coming 48. Now see the ORP level, it is going down. 48, 49, it will keep on increasing. And what I will do, again I will put the same hydrogen test in Leopure alkaline water. You see 31 32. If you see the difference between water ionizer hydrogen level and water alkaline water purifier of Leopure is almost same. There is no much difference. So my point is here, instead of spending 65,000 rupees to buy a water ionizer, you can just invest small amount for Leopure alkaline water purifier. You will get the benefit of rich hydrogen. Also you are going to get the benefit of higher pH value. Also you are going to get drink RO water if you want. You can also adjust the TDS level with the TDS adjuster. So if you want to increase the TDS level in the water. So all kinds of water purification methods available in this product. Leopure 16 stage is specially designed for those who is looking for a good water purifier in the market, comparing to the much advertised products. Thank you. Now I am going to do the chemical test using this glass. So I will collect the first tap water. I will put 10 ml of tap water into this testing. Okay. So first what I will do, alkaline testing. This is a tap water. Tap water is also alkaline, but it is not pure. Okay, you can see the pH value. It comes around about 7.5 to 8.5 range. It's 8.5 pH value. It's a tap water. Now I will throw the tap water. Okay, so I will collect different water. After tap, I will come to RO water, which I collected and stored. So I will put the same liquid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You can take 7, 8, 9, 10 like that. See the color. See the pH value. It comes to 5.5 range. This and in between this, it is not yellow also. It's orange. So RO water means you are drinking acidic water. That means every day you are drinking whiskey or beer or thumbs up pop Pepsi, which is not good for your health. Okay, so now I'll throw this water again. I'll clean the glass because there should not be any mix up. I will collect the ionized water. This is the ionized water. I'll do the pH testing for the ionized water using the same liquid solution. Now see the color. See, it's 11 pH value. When you see in the pH meter, it was showing 10 maximum. Now when you do the chemical test, it is giving 11 pH value. Because this chemical test is better than the even all these meter test. So that is the reason I was insisting to check this quality test. Now I will throw this water, ionized water, and I will collect Leopure water. This is Leopure alkaline water. I will take same 10 ml, same chemical test. See the difference. It is again 10 pH value, 10 or 9.5. So there is no much difference between water ionizer and a Leopure alkaline water purifier. Now final test, what I am going to do, I will keep all this water. Okay, you can see once again very clearly. I will just turn the glass little bit so that you can understand the color of the water. I will put the ORP solution. I will put 5 drops in each water. You see the color. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you see, both are, this is ionized water, it is alkaline water, this is tap water, this is RO water. This is all having plus ORP. This is having a negative ORP. Okay, if you just dissolve this, you see the correct color. If you do anything in this, nothing will happen. So, by buying a Leopure alkaline water purifier, Leopure ionizer, you are going to get a negative ORP water. This is the proof of that test. I have collected water from the ionizer and I collected water from the Leopure alkaline water purifier. You will not see any difference. Much difference between both the product. You can see this water also. So it is very easy for you to make a decision when you are buying a water purifier. You can get all these tests.